Hey, what's going on, everybody? Welcome back to Locker Room Talk. As always, myself, Greg Baker, Alex Ochoa, and Anthony Padilla. Hope you guys had a good Thanksgiving, but we're getting right to the talk. Lakers trades, as always. Pau Gasol is on the hot seat. Anthony, should we trade Pau? Keep Pau? If we're trading, who are we getting?
I'm for keeping Pau Gasol. Listen, he's a great player. He's been consistent for the Lakers. He puts up great numbers, and he's a very smart, you know, basketball guy. He's got a very high, you know, basketball IQ. He plays great with the bigs. He's good in the low. He can shoot the ball at a consistent percentage. He's an all-around basketball player. He's got great footwork, and I don't think anyone out there can match Pau Gasol as a power forward. I say the Lakers keep him. He's a vital piece to this Lakers team right now, especially if they want to go the distance, make it to the finals in these next 2 years with the team that they have. I think you keep Pau Gasol. You get anyone else, and they have to adjust to the offense. And besides, it's way too early in the season to think that he doesn't have what it takes. This is a revamped team. I mean, you look at Meta World Peace. He came out skinnier, a little more lean, and he's hitting his threes. Kobe Bryant looks like a new guy. You got Dwight Howard, who at 75% is playing like he's at 100 already. You can only imagine. And then you have, of course, Pau Gasol, who's gotten better himself. He's not going to be the only guy who didn't work out in the offseason.
Well, I'll tell you what, it didn't take long for us to figure Mike Brown wasn't the right choice. Five games and you're out. So, Alex, same question, Pau Gasol.
You know, the only thing I'm going to agree with you is that it's early in the season without Nash. I'm interested to see what Nash and Pau's going to look like. That's the only thing I'm going to agree with you. But as far as the numbers goes, Pau's numbers have dropped. I mean, you look Pau, I think the problem with Pau is that, and Laker fans, I hate to say this, but a lot of fans hold on to what players have done. And Pau was great when we traded him, came to L.A., we won championships. I agree with that. But Pau's numbers have dropped the last three seasons, including this season. Pau went from shooting 50% to 42%. He's still getting the same shot attempts up. He's averaging anywhere from 13 to 14 shots, and his numbers have dropped. I mean, and this is before Dwight, and this is with Dwight. So with Dwight still in the lineup, taking away some of his touches and rebounds, he's still throwing up the same amount of shots. Look, Pau is soft. He's soft, and he's soft. And this team is not going to get any better with Pau. I say with Pau right now, he still holds value. Teams still want him. You trade something good and get something good in return. And I'm not even talking about a Josh Smith. I'm talking about fixing the problem with this team, and that's the bench. I'm looking at a Kyle Korver, Anthony Morrow. I'm not really too up on Josh Smith. I say fix the bench and fix it now, because this team is not going to win. They haven't won with Pau the last two seasons. What makes you think they're going to win with him now?
You know, it's funny that you say that. When you got a Pau Gasol who is a valuable player, and I wouldn't get rid of him. He's got 2 years left on his contract. Let him play him out in the Lakers. The chemistry he has with his team, with Kobe Bryant, with Meta World Peace, it's beyond unbelievable. And to get rid of that, to get rid of what he brings to this team, the footwork, the way he can pass the ball, his assists. And let's not forget, he's had a couple games where he's had to keep the Lakers afloat early in the game until everyone else can get it going. That's something very valuable. And his numbers are not that far off than they were last year, except for his shooting percentage.
Well, you talk about Meta and Kobe Bryant. I mean, he's been playing with them for 2 or 3 years. And the last 2 years, we haven't made the finals.
Yeah, the whole problem with this is Pau Gasol was a great brand for the triangle offense, the Princeton offense. That's great having that kind of passer. But that's not what we have here. We have the D'Antoni offense, and he is not running down the floor. I mean, you guys are already seeing stories about his conditioning. How the hell do you have poor conditioning after being in the Olympics and playing a full season?
Well, I'm sorry. Let me just say really quick. We lost the last 2 years because of Andrew Bynum. Without Andrew Bynum, I mean, we got Dwight Howard, and we're doing a whole lot better. I'm just saying.
But Powell's numbers have dropped the past two playoff seasons. They just dropped, and his numbers have dropped this season. He's averaging 14 points, so his numbers being consistent and up there, I doubt it. He got traded from Memphis. He was averaging 18 points. Came to LA, was averaging 18 points the first two seasons. This season, the same shot attempts, same amount of shot attempts, and now even having a better big that takes away from him, not being double teamed, and his numbers have dropped, man. They've dropped.
But they're still winning games, Alex, and that's because of Dwight Howard's defense and what he brings to the team that Andrew Bynum didn't.
Look at the standings right now. Are they going to beat the Clippers?
Oh, yeah.
And that, you know what? That brings us to another point, though, that you made. It comes back to the bench. Like you said, if you're going to trade Pau, do it to fix our problem, which is the bench. Alex, that being said, what is the problem with the bench right now?
I've been saying it for the past couple of shows. If you've been watching, it's Anton Jameson. I mean, it was a great move to bring Anton. It was. I mean, the guy was averaging 16, 17 points a game. I mean, who would have thought he was going to be a bust? I mean, Jody Meeks has had a better game than Anton Jameson. I mean, Mitch did what he did. I mean, great moves. Nothing against him. It's just Anton Jameson lost his mojo, and he hasn't been able to get it back. And I just feel like he's so uncomfortable out there. And now with this type of offense where it's going to be a run-and-gun offense, I was hoping he'd get some shots up, and he has, but he's just not hitting them, man. And this Jordan Hill is great off the bench. Meeks is a little inconsistent, but he's getting his playing time now. They have to fix this bench and go back to Powell. He's valuable. He holds value right now. Trade him. Powell's making $19 million a year and next year. Is Powell really worth $19 million to you guys these next 2 years if they're not going to win the championship?
If we didn't have three other superstars on the starting lineup, I'd say yeah. But Anthony, how do you feel about the bench?
You know, I gotta agree with Alex. The bench is just inconsistent right now. People aren't doing what they're supposed to do coming off of the bench. Darius Morris, I think, is a diamond in the rough. He's coming out really showing what he can do, and I think he can easily take Steve Blake's spot. With that being said, I think Jordan Hill's coming out. Anton Jamison, like Alex said, is not the guy we thought he was going to be. He's coming off the bench, and right now nobody really knows him right now. If he didn't play for the Cavs and put up the numbers he did then, he'd be another face on the bench, yeah, to be honest.
You brought up Morris. A lot of people are asking, you know, who should be our backup point guard, Steve Blake or Morris? Alex, how do you feel about those two? Who's your pick?
Man, Morris has showed a lot of potential from last year to this year. I mean, I really like what he's bringing to this team. But the only thing I'm going to hold on to is D'Antoni made a comment during his press conference where he talked about that he's been chasing Blake for the past like 10 years. So I'm really excited to see what he's talking about. But if he doesn't do what he's supposed to do, I like Morris coming behind Nash.
You know, I like Morris. I like what Morris brings on defense. He can come out and guard some of the best point guards. And, I mean, we saw in the last few games, he struggled a little bit against Deron Williams playing against the Brooklyn Nets. But aside from that, he brings intensity, hustle. He's not focused on scoring. He makes the right passes. And he just knows how to hold his composure together. When games are low and he makes a bad pass, he comes right back and he's back at it. I like what he brings, his confidence. And again, big thing, defense, because that's what the Lakers lack as a team. And especially coming off the bench when you have a lead, you want someone to come off that can hold the lead. And that's Darius Morris to me.
You know, Morris, Blake, I take a Jose Calderon, Mitch. Make it happen. Lakers Nation, that's going to do it for us this week. Make sure you keep tuning in at Lakers LRT on Twitter, Facebook as well. And we'll see you next week.